A bike. Man, I need one of those. Nothing like a bunch of rusty barrels to make you want to rent a bike. Maybe they're planning on holding a crucifixion later. Somebody lives there. Probably someone with a penchant for rusty barrels. Looks like an accident waiting to happen. Kinda like my life. A trash heap. That's one way to draw a crowd. Of flies, anyway. I need to rent a bike. Oh, check out that Harley. Wow, I'd love to drive that baby. What a pathetic excuse for a bike. What a pathetic... It's a moped rental shop. It's a reservation list for the bikes.
I'm not on it. Great! They're open!
Hey, how you doing? I want to rent a bike.
Oui, your passport, please. Monsieur Knight, you are not with the tour group? I do not see you on my list.
Nope, I'm on my own.
Ah, I am sorry, monsieur, but most of my fleet is reserved for the tour group.
What?
I have one little bike left, monsieur, but she is nothing grand. I show you. Here she is.
This piece of crap? Oh, come on. I was kind of hoping for this baby. Ooh, what is this, a WW2 army issue?
Oui, but the tour group reservations were made first. It is this little bike, monsieur, or nothing.
Well, who gets the Harley?
Whoever chooses it first, monsieur. If none of the others want the large bike, you may have it.
Oh, yeah, like that's gonna happen.
Well, let me know what you decide.
I don't have a gun. That guy is seriously ruining my day. I'm not gonna be able to charm my way into that Harley. I'll have to think of something else. It's a reservation list for the bikes.
I'm not on it.
Well, I'm not on the reservation list, but I know someone who is.
Man, I really want that bike. I wouldn't be caught dead on that bike. A thing like that can ruin a guy's self-esteem permanently.
Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
I noticed y'all moving suitcases around upstairs. Was there a problem with your room?
Oh, my, yes.
But that wasn't why we moved, Lily.
No?
Mr. Barza kindly offered to exchange with us.
He's a Muslim, you see. Wanting to be facing east and all that. Well, Estelle and I are very much in favour of supporting the cultural differences between us, aren't we, darling?
Yes, Lily. And it's a much nicer room. It's larger and has a balcony.
Of course, I do appreciate the sacrifice. But then there are two of us and only one of Mr. Barza. And I'm sure he's used to stuffier quarters. Middle Easterners so often are, you see.
Yeah, I've heard that.
I could, but maybe I should wait until Jean's elsewhere.
He's going down to the lobby.
If I could get him to stop somewhere for a minute, I might be able to, well, to do some. I better get out of here before Mount Everest returns. I suppose this hat might be useful after all. Looks like Arno has a green thumb. It's the parsonage door. Yeah, I could bug him, but maybe I'll wait until he's out and about. Minimalistic gardening. Kind of like my approach to relationships. And what exactly would I do with that? Arno is at home. It's for a worthy cause. Really piled the cement on top of this one. There's a heart-shaped sign in the wall. E.C. Repose, Mademoiselle Marie Denarnot. Died January 1953 at 85 years old. These two graves have cement slabs poured over them. It's Saunier's grave. That must be Saunier himself. He's looked a little worse for wear. It's a cross. Can't see any writing on it or anything. It's Saunier's grave. It's Saunier's grave. Shade for the dead. That is important. Here's a newer one, relatively speaking. Duke de Rays, 1700s. Here's a newer one, relative. It says Jacques Girard, 1792 to 1861. Hey, I wonder if he could be the Jacques of Frere Jacques. Probably not. A few of these stones have a star on them. I can't read it. The letters have worn away. Here's a newer one. Abigail passed on in 1893. This one's from the turn of the century. Last century. Poor Pierre. He was only 34. Of course, that's 238 in dog years. Gee, a pirate must be buried here. It's the back of the church. That window is in the abbé's office. This one's 20th century. Louis Hoffet kicked it in 1964. This one's 20th century. Maxine Lafitte. She died in the 70s. Can't say I blame her. A black cat. How appropriate. That cat's got some major black fur going. I might be able to use some of that. That shed looks like it hasn't seen the light of day in a couple of years. Reminds me of a garage I had once. It's padlocked. I don't think I need to bust my way into that shed. It's probably just full of spider webs. Now that's what I call weathering. Some people pay a fortune to get this stuff to look like that. You try to share a little human kindness, and what does it get you? That's a tight squeeze, but the cat hasn't left any fur behind on those boards. He might, though, with a little help. It's a long piece of masking tape, still sticky, too. The cat ran through there. Pretty tight squeeze, too. It worked! It's the hat from the museum's lost and found. I know what you're thinking, but I might need it. I'm not really a hat person myself. That's more like something Mosley would wear. It's Mosley's gold Caldwell Banker style blazer. He's had this since the Saturday Night Fever premiere. The coat's a start, but if I really want to do a Mosley look, I'm going to have to put some stuff with it. It's starting to come together. That outfit looks pathetically Mosley-like, but my face is still way too good-looking. I think that'll pass for a black mustache, but it's not going to stay on my lip without help, despite my intense animal magnetism. Maple syrup. It's a black mustache. Sort of. It's crude, but it just might work. Now that's a Mosley outfit. Tacky, touristy, moronic, it's perfect. If anybody sees me in this thing, I'll have to leave town immediately. If anybody sees me in this thing, I'll have to... I've got a disguise and I've got a passport, but I need to do something about that face on the passport or he'll know it isn't me. And some people think I give America. That's better. The mustaches should help disguise the obvious disparity between his face and mine. Unfortunately for Mose, things aren't quite that simple in real life. No peeking.
Hey, is this where y'all rent mopeds?
Oui. May I see your passport? Ah, Monsieur Mosley. Yes, I have a reservation for you. One moment. You may have any bike in the lot, Monsieur.
I can? Heck. I guess I'll take this big old hog hire. How much is that?
100 francs a day.
Looks like we got us a deal.
There you are, monsieur. You pay when you return the bike.
Golly, thanks.
But wait, the tour group gets my special treasure chest package. You get the binoculars and the shovel with that.
Oh, great.
Best of luck, monsieur. If you strike it rich, you will remember poor little Bigot, will you not?
That's right. I will not. Thank you so much.
Whew, man, the things I'll do for a decent back. Oh, I better put this stuff back before Mosley has a conniption. That sign's for the moped rental shop.
Man, I really want that bike.
I wouldn't be caught dead on that bike.
Good thing that sign's there, or I'd swear this was a garage. Wow, classic chassis. The owner wouldn't like it. Besides, I prefer the back. The French really enjoy their barrels, don't they? Cheap seating and storage facilities in one. They must watch the tracks from up there. Why is another matter. The great and magnificent Couisa train station. Proof that the great iron way really does go everywhere. I'm not sure what all these buildings are, but I don't think they're connected to the station. I wonder if that guy runs a taxi service. He might have been around last night.
Hi there.
Oh, it's you. Haha. You are feeling better, I hope. That was a nasty bump you had on the head last night.
Sure. You took me over to Rennes Le Chateau, right?
Yes. You must remember the car. You said it had a smell like the garlic. Probably my dog, Fifi. He loves to eat the garlic, and then he...
Yeah, well, thanks for jogging my memory.
Oh, it's my pleasure, monsieur.
You were here last night. Did you see two men with a trunk come out of that station just before I did?
Yes, but they didn't need a ride from me.
No, what'd they do?
They drove off, monsieur.
Yes, but how? Did they have a car parked here?
No. Well, yes, I guess it was parked at the time.
Could you tell me exactly what you saw? Two men with a trunk came out of the train station and...
I'm having a hard time remembering.
I get the feeling he's holding out on me. He must want something. the Great? I'm guessing it says the trains are that-a-way. There's a piece of paper in the sand. Looks like someone was a bit too eager to flick. Looks like some... Either that means tickets in French, or they've got a side business going in munitions. There's a girl in the ticket booth. That's helpful.
Hello there, mademoiselle.
Bonjour. Where is it you wish to go?
I'm already there. I want to ask you a few questions.
Oui. All right.
Do you have a record of a man getting off the Naples train last night?
There was no train from Naples last night, monsieur. We have very limited service.
Is that so? What trains did come in?
We have a set schedule, monsieur. The trains are listed on the board.
What other trains had passengers disembark last night?
Un moment. There was one passenger from Rome, none from Madrid, two from Nice earlier in the day.
Great, thanks. Did two men with a trunk come in from Paris yesterday evening?
We had three arrivals last night from Paris, but I have no idea who they were.
Do you know where they went?
Mais no. We only keep a record of the number who arrive, and only that because there is some talk of cutting service to Guiza. We have few visitors, and most of them come by auto.
Cute kid. She works here. I don't think she can tell me anything more. It's a list of arrivals and departures. Those are the trains you can catch from here. Daily, Paris and Bordeaux, Tuesday and Thursday, Rome and Madrid. Not a lot of options if you want to leave Coisa. The departures won't help me much. My gut instinct tells me the baby's still in the area. It's a list of arrivals. It's a list of arrivals. Yesterday was Wednesday, so the only trains that came in were from Nice, Paris, Madrid, and Rome. There is no Naples route. In other words, Buccelli is lying. Either he didn't take the train at all, or he didn't take the one he says he took. That way leads to the trains. I'm not taking one that I know of. This must be the place the Abbé told me about. That must be Chester's car. That tree must come in handy. It gets damn hot around here. What could I see from back there? It's not high enough to keep anybody out. Must be for marking the property line. And where exactly would I be going to? Kind of big for a garden ornament. No, really. There's nothing down there but water. That's what I call the lived-in look. There is a hole in the window, but it's not a very big one. It's a window. Crucifying rabbits, maybe? This must be the place the Abbé told me about. This house is hardly big enough for one door. I'd rather use the front door. I don't know, it's just more formal somehow.
Hello. May I help you?
I hope so. The name is Knight. Gabriel Knight. The Abbé at Rennes-le-Château recommended you as a Templar scholar.
Did he now?
Yep. He said, go talk to Larry Chester about the Templars. And then he said, and let me know what you think.
Well, in that case, you'd better come in. Can I get you some tea?
No, thank you.
Now then, what can I do for you, Mr. Knight?
Madame Girard mentioned that the Holy Grail is sometimes linked to the Templars.
It is, yes. In many of the early Grail legends, the knights were described as Templars, wearing the white mantle with a red cross.
She said something about them actually finding the Grail in the Holy Land. Do you think that's possible?
Yes, I do.
So you think the Templars found the Holy Grail in Jerusalem and brought it back here?
Let me put it this way. When the Templars were founded in 1118, there were 9 knights. Their stated purpose was to protect pilgrims on the road. But for years they did nothing of the sort. They were given quarters in the Temple of Solomon by King Baudouin himself. There they stayed. And there they excavated for 9 years. Then, In 1128, they changed completely. They returned to Europe and began recruiting. Their wealth and power grew on an unprecedented curve.
So you do think they found the Grail?
I think you're taking the legend of the Grail a little too literally. As with many things of the Middle Ages, it was often wiser and safer to speak in allegory.
What's the Holy Grail an allegory of?
I have a feeling that will come to light sometime in the next decade.
The Abbé mentioned that you're working on a book.
Yes, I'm a historian.
And you're writing about the Templars?
No, exactly. This area is rich in Templar history. That's why I thought I'd come here to write. It's a kind of sabbatical, really.
A sabbatical from what?
I teach at a prep school in Manchester.
Is there any reason to think the Templars left something here, specifically?
It's not unknown that the Templars were digging in the region. They claimed they were mining the old Roman gold veins, but they hired only German workers who couldn't communicate with the locals. Naturally, that led to some speculation.
I read in the museum that several of the Templar founders and a Grand Master were from this region.
That's true. They also had several bases here and owned a great deal of land. The Chateau de Serres, for example, was built on top of an old Templar fortress.
Why were the Templars accused of heresy?
There are many theories, but most scholars agree that King Philip was jealous of their authority. He wanted to confiscate their land and their reputed treasure. Unfortunately, the Templars themselves helped him make his case. They boasted of the secrets they'd learned in the Holy Land.
Secrets?
Mystical secrets from Kabbalists and Arabic astronomers. Of course, to Christendom, this was nothing but witchcraft. Those who confessed were released. Those who did not were burnt at the stake, including the last Grand Master, Jacques Molay.
And they dissolved completely after that?
The Knights Templar were no more, yes.
The Templars had a lot of wealth, right? Gold, money, land.
Absolutely.
And that's one possibility for the alleged local treasure? The Templar stash?
Yes, but...
You don't think so?
They had warning before their arrest. Perhaps some chose to believe that the church would ultimately protect them, but they had enough sense to move the treasure.
To where?
There are various locations. Ireland and Scotland have a great deal of Templar history, for example.
If the Templars smuggled out their treasure, wouldn't that sort of blow the Grail theory?
Perhaps there were some things that were too large or too, localized to take with them. No, they left something behind in the Languedoc. You can be sure of that, Mr. Knight.
Larry Chester. He's supposed to be writing a book on the Templars. I don't have anything else to say to him. I prefer an old manual myself. Yep, he's a writer, all right. Only writers have this many books. I can't make it out from here, and he'd probably get upset if I took it with me. Yep, he's a right. Boy, can you imagine the exciting stuff in this guy's files? I think he'd mind. It's a clock, an alarm clock. Why would I want to do that? Yep, he's a rider. Yep. That painting's about as colorful as Larry himself. The guy's into maps.
Thanks for the info, Mr. Chester.
You're most welcome. What is your interest in the Templars, if you don't mind my asking?
No, I don't mind. Thanks again.
Rock Negra. Black Rock. Chateau de Blanchefort. They even label their mountains around here. I'd get all muddy climbing down. There's a stream down there. I can't see it too well, but I can hear it. There's a shower back at the hotel. I don't have my hiking boots on. Must be trying to cash in on the treasure hunting crowd. Deader than a Bob Dole rally. Deader than a Bob Dole rally. I doubt there's anybody in there that can help with the case. Reminds me of the Golden Erloa in Rittersburg. I can't see in. The curtains are closed. It's a makeshift parking lot. They're opaque from all the cigarette smoke. cozy. But if I'm going to be in a bar, I prefer to sit as close to the poison as possible. A lion-shaped map. Weird. It's a big old sword. Cool. I already got my knife. How romantic. A guy could do well in a place like this. Reminds me of the Hunt Club. I might have to use one of these eventually, but for now I'll stick with my tape recorder and notebook. Thank you. Either they have really big darts here in France, or that thing's been played to death. They got a travel theme happening here. Ooh, the local watering trough. There for sitting. I could sit down, but I guess I got more important business at the moment. Call me crazy, but my guess is he's the bartender. Hey, how's business?
Désolé, je ne parle pas anglais.
Okay.
Place called Coon Sword. It's Madeline's van, all right. I followed her here. Coombe Sword. Well, whatever it is, it's down that path. It's a sign about the area. A stone slab called the Dal de Coombe Sword was discovered at this spot. This slab allegedly contained encoded messages related to the Wren's enigma, but it has since vanished. Coombe Sword still draws curious seekers hoping for more clues. So they found the stone slab that could have been the key to the mystery, and then they lost it? Figures. There were buildings here once. There's not a lot of growth going on in this area, is there? Now, what is she up to? Not the best way to get on her good side. She's just hanging out, isn't she? Ooh, if I thought about her for too long, I'd be walking funny. Fancy meeting a girl like you in a place like this.
Oh, hello, Monsieur Knight.
That sin, are we?
I am refreshing my memory for tomorrow.
Tomorrow? You mean for that tour thing? So what's so special about this place?
Nothing. And anyway, you are not taking the tour, so why do you care?
You got a point there.
I don't think she's in the mood for company. That's Chateau de Blanchefort up there. It's a diagram of the chateau that used to be here. Not much left of the place, is there? Mount Cardew must be the big mountain across the road. That's a nice looking mountain, if you're into that nature stuff. There's a big orange rock off the road over there. There's a little valley over there. There's that big black rock you can see from the road. That's Rennes le Château over there. Not what you might call your major metropolis, is it? Well, you see, they make things that are far away look real close-like. The Bannocks came with the Harley. There was a tower. There was a tower here. Pulled off at a little parking lot. That's Wilkes' moped. Wilkes is here doing something with that machine of his. Probably some high-tech version of a water dowser, and probably useless. A good writer never goes anywhere without his notepad. FED-039A is Wilkes's moped. Guess I should make a note of it. Got it. Lermitage. Wonder what that means. Thanks. The last time I went poking around in a cave, I ended up with hair on my palms. Pillars outside a cave? Maybe Lermitage means weird-ass architecture. This is obviously some sort of tourist site. This little cave has been identified as Lermitage on regional maps for centuries, but the origins of its ownership and usage remain obscure. Wow, that's fascinating. I'll have to write home about that one. What the heck is that thing? I'm thinking, but I haven't a clue. Wilkes's computer. How does he get his big fingers on those little keys? He's probably searching the web for the most macho contest results. You know, those are the guys who pick up automobiles with their teeth and cut off their own heads with chainsaws. He just looks the type. It's Wilkes, the Australian.
Hey, Wilkes, how's it going?
Beachy. What are you doing out here?
Just taking in the sights. L'Hermitage. Cute.
Yeah, right.
Say, mind if I ask about your machine?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, come on. What is it? You trying to call a giant sandworm or what?
For your information, Knight, this is highly delicate scientific equipment.
Yeah, so is a worm thumper. So, see anything headed this way? Should we head for the rocks?
Shut the hell up, Knight.
Look, it's a giant worm. Get out the harpoons.
Ah, for Christ. This is a seismic survey machine, Knight. Now shut the hell up before I thump you.
A seismic survey machine? What's it do?
Forget it, Knight. Get your own damn theory.
You really think there's a treasure out here?
Oh, there's a treasure, all right, mate.
Yeah? What do you think it is?
You know what Sonia's girlfriend said, don't you? People are walking around on gold and don't even know it. The Romans mined here, and back then, they knew how to use slave labor, right? Plus all them kings that was around here. Those guys had regular hordes of valuables, and some of it's bound to have gotten lost.
Well, I guess so.
And the bloke that finds it is going to be flat-out stinking rich. And I'll tell you a secret, mate. That bloke is going to be me.
You seem pretty sure about finding that treasure.
That's right. But I ain't gonna tell you about it, so don't ask.
So, you don't think the treasure's related to the Grail?
Holy Grail. Yeah, that's a right one. Did you know the Nazis crawled all over this valley looking for it?
No.
What a bunch of jackasses. Hey, I was thinking, if I find an old enough cup, right? Maybe one with some jewels and shit on it. I could pass it off for the Grail. Especially if it came from around here.
Gee, there's an idea.
Sure. If Hitler believed all that mystical crap, there's got to be somebody else who believe it. Maybe dish out some serious cash.
It's Wilkes, the Australian. I don't have anything else to say to him.